Good evening. I'm going to do a quick and dirty review of iGear's PP03 Jet, other known as not Ramjet. So here we go. Here's the box. Kind of give you a full view of every side here. Kind of a simple graphic. So all are one. And of course your choking hazard warning. Gotta have that. One thing to take note is that the box is exactly the same size as the traditional Masterpiece Seeker boxes. Let's see what's inside. Okay, when you open them up, this is what you get. You get not Ramjet, you get the black stand, and the other part of the stand, scientist guy, and a little holder thing for Megatron when he's in gun mode. But you'll see I have this part missing, and the reason is this set had the missiles missing from the set. And how do I know that? Because I had bought two sets and the other one did include them. So I'm currently working out how to get my missing missiles. We also have the instruction manual, which really is not an instruction manual. It's more of a comic. Kind of cool. Of course, the last page shows iGear's upcoming Ratchet and Ironhide figures. You get this cool little hard plastic card. With his specs. And of course, stickers. And as you can see, there are no copyrighted or trademarked stickers. They're all pretty unique or generic. I want to touch briefly on some QC issues, and one major one here is putting the stand together. This connection right here, there's something wrong with the mold where there is just not enough clearance to smoothly slide it in. It's very stiff. Anyway, if you force it, you're going to end up bending the plastic, and if you need to take it off, you could possibly snap something. So I'm trying to think of a good way to maybe shave off some plastic so it fits properly. Of course, with the official Transformer or Takara and Hasbro releases, they slide on perfectly without any issue. All right, well, let's look at some of the details while he's in jet mode here. I turned the brightness down on my camera to try to get a little bit more of the detail. As you can see, the paint is just bleach white. It's super bright, and with too much lighting it just washes out. Now, I'm not a Masterpiece Transformers expert, but there's a few things that caught my attention. Here you can see that the tip of the tail fin here is rounded, whereas on a Takara release, they're nice and pointy sharp. So you could say this is more kid friendly. And I didn't connect the stand fully. Of course the nose opens up. Let's increase the brightness here. And this is straight out of the box. I haven't even transformed him yet. You can tell that the wings are actually painted, which looks pretty nice. Here's a view of the underside. And you can just barely see where the cone head is kind of stuck in there. A little bit of die cast, that's never bad. Okay, here he is transform, but two things. Quality. If you see that little piece of plastic, then you can see where it came from. It snapped off the end of the I don't even know what part you call it. Little pointy tip. Didn't do anything. I was just transforming him and it barely touched my hand and it just kinda fell off. There's the other side fully on. So I'm a little bit disappointed about that. But I can't say I haven't had QC issues with Takara Masterpiece Transformers either. So it's kinda disappointing. Second thing, let me just get this out of the way. I know many of you will point out how I mistransformed this guy. So let's just get that out of the air here and say, hey, this is the first time I transformed this guy. I'm not a Transformers expert like you. This is the best I can do before dinner. With that being said, while transforming him, I felt like I was transforming Megatron because this guy is delicate. Several pieces just felt really light, almost flimsy. I didn't really get a feel that I could just kind of transform him and not really care. Like if I was transforming the Hasbro Starscream, you know, I don't know what they did differently, but it's a lot more rugged. But let's look at some of the details. So here's his head. It's a nice little cone on top. And as you can see, it's just a ball joint. It's kind of on the loose side. I think his head's kind of small in proportion to the rest of the figure, especially when you look at Starscream. Yeah, it just seems like a more proportioned head. But I think the few paint applications they put on this figure is well done. There's him talking to Starscream. Left arm, if you can see it, sound wave. And of course these things open up. of course, one of the more innovative changes they made to the mold are the rear wings and the elimination of the hip kibble. But now I have leg kibble. But that's okay, it looks all right. So that's all I got. I'm gonna go eat dinner. Hope you enjoyed the video, and I look forward to seeing everybody else's reviews.